you know, until you're maybe making six figures in what you're doing on the side, I always think have a backup plan. You know, chase your dreams, but know what you're doing when you chase them. Herman Ham grew up in New Haven, started promoting years ago, probably for the last 20 years I've been promoting. I would hire local DJs that lived here in the Connecticut area. And after that, I kind of went into working with one DJ only. I had a DJ, Grand Wizard Stevie D. We did a lot of parties together for about 3 years. And after a while, he kind of talked me into going out buying some turntables. I was DJing around town. And a lot of people knew me. I got a huge following. People, you know, would hit me up on Facebook, start asking me where parties are going to be at for the weekend. So that's basically what happened. So what made me not do the 9-to-5? I actually always had a 9-to-5. So actually, I have a limo company. I'm in the limo business. But it kind of, I don't know, it was just sitting at the office. And I kind of like to deal with people. The whole customer service being one-on-one. Out in the field, so it's a little different. With the limo company, it's answering phones and behind the scenes, even though there's customer service when it comes to the phones and dealing back and forth with customers, I kind of like the one-on-one, face-to-face with people and making people happy through my events. So what made me excel with my entertainment company as fast that other people may not excel as quickly? I think I excelled because I went from promoting, I already had a huge following with people coming to my parties. So even when I went into DJing, I think people wanted to come out and support me. So when I went to the entertainment company, a lot of people right now who call me are some of the same people who come support me at my parties. My parties. My parties. My parties. One thing that I love most about my job, I think, is dealing with people and making people happy. I mean, people come to me, and to me, it's a huge responsibility. It's totally different than me being a promoter. You want people to come out to a party and have a great time. But to me, I walk in a venue, put somebody at the door to collect money, put a DJ in there, and put some security guards at the door. You know, you want to have people in a safe environment. So they do come out so they can be in a safe, nice, clean environment. So I think I just like making people happy. To make someone happy, it makes me happy to see them having a good time. And it's the same as when I was a promoter. You love to see people come out and, you know, I had people celebrate their birthdays with me year round. And they come back to me the following year and the year after. And then they're tagging themselves and making pictures from my party, their profile picture. You know, just to see that and the comments that they'll put on Facebook about how much of a great time they had, I think that makes me happy, seeing happiness in them. The one piece of advice I would give somebody who wanted to go into business that I'm doing is customer service. That's first. You know, I conduct myself a certain way because you never know who's watching you or who's looking at you. So even on Facebook, you know, some people just see my Facebook page. And they see a couple of events I'm promoting and then they contact me. So I think it's the customer service. If you don't put your clients first, I think you're set up for failure. So what is my take on the new normal, the normal in general? To tell my story, everybody might not be able to do it the way I did. You know, I went to high school, I graduated. I didn't go to college. I went to Catherine Gibbs. On the side, took up computer technical support. Didn't even finish through with that. But to me, I don't like my kids, I push to go to college. I tell anybody education is, you know, the way to go. I didn't go to college. For me, I went out and hustled. I went out and got the limo job, and it was just like, I did real estate. So it was sort of like hustling with employment. I did the real estate, had a limo job, went from promoting to entertainment company. I would tell people, do what you feel is natural, what's comfortable for you. I wouldn't tell anybody to get out of high school and throw away college and go on this dream that they're not sure of. You know, I want to be a rapper. I want to be a singer. You really have to know what you're doing and have a backup plan. That's the thing with me. I've always had a backup plan. Even right now with the entertainment company going so well, my 9-to-5 that I get a check from, he is my limo company, job. And I don't want to say I could, but I probably could leave the limo job and just do the entertainment company. But to me, it's a sense, it's a backup or a sense of security. I can pay my mortgage with my with my limo job. You know, why get rid of that and then pay the mortgage through the entertainment company? So to me, it's you know, until you're maybe making six figures in what you're doing on the side, I always think, have a backup plan. You know, chase your dreams, but know what you're doing when you chase them. I think you really have to just have a foundation, do research, and, you know, don't throw away education, because sometimes you can go into the education after high school, go to college with something that might help a dream that you want to do on the side, even if it don't have anything to do with what you went to college for. Just that discipline that they give you in college can help people in the long run.
Appreciate it.
Hey.
Appreciate you. I probably live longer than you and never fade away. I'll never fade away. I'll never fade away. I know my fate and I'm on the ground for this cake. I'ma get it or die trying. I'm eyeing every male gender with intentions of buying.